Unlike most other systems of our body, the immune system is special because it is not localized to a specific region or a specific organ of the body. Instead, our immune system is spread out throughout the entire body. It is found in many different regions of the body. Now, as we'll see in the next several lectures, what the immune system does is it utilizes a series of internal defense mechanisms that ultimately protect the cells of our body from pathogens. And a pathogen is any type of agent, it can be living or non-living, that brings harm to the cells of our body. So a bacterial cell, a virus, a chemical that can harm our cells, all these different things are considered to be pathogens. Now, for a pathogen to actually cause damage, cause harm to the cells of our body, these pathogens must enter our body. And the most common ways by which pathogens enter our body is through the simple process of breathing. When we exchange air inside our lungs, that can bring different types of pathogens into our body. Pathogens can also enter our body through the food that we eat, through the water that we drink, or through some type of cut that is found on our skin. Now, in order for our immune system to actually be effective and efficient, it must have a way to actually differentiate, to actually distinguish between its own cells of the body and these foreign pathogens that can cause harm to those cells of the body. Now, such recognition is actually possible because the cells of our body contain special unique macromolecules, for example, proteins or lipoproteins that are found on the membrane of the cells of the body, and our immune system can use these unique biological molecules on the membrane to recognize its own cells. Now, on the other side of things, if we examine a pathogen, for example, a bacterial cell, bacterial cells also contain their own unique biological molecules, macromolecules, on the membrane. And the our immune system can ultimately use these foreign macromolecules to stimulate the immune system to initiate a response that ultimately destroys and kills off that pathogen. And in general, anytime we have a substance, such as the macromolecule found on the membrane of the bacterial cell, that stimulates any type of immune response, this substance is known as an antigen. So our immune system uses these foreign antigens to basically stimulate these internal defense mechanisms that ultimately catch these pathogens and destroy these pathogens. So to see what we mean, let's take a look at the following diagram. So these are two human cells. This is a pathogen, for example, a bacterial cell. Notice that both of these cells actually contain these membrane-bound macromolecules. For example, let's suppose they're lipoproteins. Now, these lipoproteins that the human cell contains are easily recognized by the cells of our immune system. And so, these membrane protein of human cells can be used by the immune system in self-recognition. And that ensures that the our own immune system doesn't actually destroy our own cells. On the other hand, these foreign macromolecules or antigens can be recognized by the immune cells as foreign objects, and so our immune system can initiate a series of internal defense mechanisms that ultimately destroy our foreign object, our bacterial cell. Now, if we take our immune system, the immune system can basically be divided into two types. The first type is known as the non-specific or the innate immune system, and the second division is known as the specific or the acquired immune system. So if we look at our immune system, it could be subdivided into two categories. We have the innate immunity, also known as non-specific immunity, and we have the acquired immunity, also known as the specific immunity. Now, what exactly is the difference between between these two immunity systems? Well, this takes in effect immediately as soon as that pathogen actually enters our body, while our acquired immunity takes several days to actually kick in. Now, the innate immunity doesn't actually involve any process of learning, but the acquired immunity requires the process of learning. For example, if a bacterial cell actually infects our body, then the next time that same type of cell infects our body, it's the acquired immune system that is responsible for initiating the response that recognizes that specific type of bacterial cell and kills off that bacterial cell. So this is very specific to the type of cells, the type of pathogens it actually attacks, while this type of system does not actually discriminate. It attacks all different types of pathogens equally. So let's begin by discussing our innate immunity and the different components that make up our innate immunity. And let's begin with the physical barrier, our skin. So our skin is the largest organ of our body, and one of the more important functions of our skin is to actually physically protect our body from different types of pathogens, for example, UV radiation, as well as bacterial cells and viruses. So our skin creates a physical barrier that prevents pathogens from entering our body and attacking our cells. Now, if we examine the passageways inside our body, the air passageways, including the nasal cavity, the trachea, the bronchi, as well as the bronchioles found in the lungs, these air passageways are lined with a special type of mucous membrane. And this sticky and slimy mucous membrane is responsible for trapping the pathogens that enter our body through the process of breathing. And once these pathogens are trapped inside our mucous membrane, the cilia found inside the passageways carry those pathogens up to the outside of our body and sometimes into our stomach. And that leads us directly to number three, fluid secretions. So why would we want any sort of pathogen to actually enter our stomach? Well, basically, if we ingest any type of food that contains a pathogen, or if the pathogens inside the mucous membrane are eventually expelled into our stomach, the reason this actually takes place is because inside our stomach, we have specialized types of cells known as parietal cells that are responsible for secreting a very acidic substance known as hydrochloric acid. And the hydrochloric acid creates a very low pH, a very acidic environment that most pathogens cannot actually survive in. On top of that, our skin, our mouth, and eyes also contain special types of glands that secrete other fluids that contain enzymes such as lysozymes that can essentially kill off our bacterial cells, pathogens, because they break down the cell membrane of those bacterial cells. Now, the fourth type of innate immunity section is the phagocytes and neutrophils. These are two types of cells, specialized immune cells, that are part of the innate immunity response. Now, these two cells are essentially cells that can engulf our pathogen and destroy that pathogen once they actually engulf. Now, these cells aren't specific to the type of pathogen they actually engulf. They engulf anything that is foreign to the body. And finally, we also have the process of inflammation and fever. So different types of chemicals inside our body can initiate the process of inflammation. And as we'll see in the next several lectures, what inflammation actually does, it localizes our infection and it helps bring different types of immune agents, for example, phagocytes and neutrophils, to that infected area. Now, fever is another type of innate immunity response, because what fever basically does is it increases the temperature of our body, and that can destroy the bacterial cells because cells cannot actually survive in that particular temperature environment. Now, let's move on to acquired immunity. So we have two divisions of acquired immunity, which takes usually several days to actually kick in. We have cell-mediated immunity, also known as T-cell immunity, and we also have antibody-mediated immunity, also known as B-cell immunity or humoral immunity. So the major difference between these two types of divisions of the acquired immunity is one uses a type of cell known as a T-lymphocyte or a T-cell, and the second type uses a type of cell known as a B-lymphocyte or a B-cell. And number two, this uses a special type of biological molecule known as an antibody, and we'll see what that is in just a moment. So let's begin with the cell-mediated immunity. So this immune response involves special defense cells, immune cells known as T lymphocytes. And we have several types of T lymphocytes or T cells. We have killer T cells, we have suppressor T cells, we have helper T cells, we also have memory T cells. And we'll discuss these different types of T lymphocytes in the next several lectures. Now, the main function of these T lymphocytes is to actually recognize different types of pathogens, different types of bacterial cells and infected cells by using the antigens found on the surface of those infected and bacterial cells. So these cells have a special protein on their membrane that can recognize foreign antigens and kill off those pathogens. Now let's move on to the antibody mediated immunity. So this involves not T lymphocytes, but B lymphocytes or B cells. And we also have different types of B cells. We have plasma B cells and we have memory B cells. And we'll discuss their unique individual function in the next several lectures. So these cells are responsible for producing a type of biological immune or defense molecule known as the antibody. So antibodies are essentially these proteins that circulate throughout our blood, and they can attach and recognize the antigens of bacterial cells and other pathogens. And by binding to these antigens, what the antibodies do is they help our immune system initiate these defense mechanisms that ultimately kill off those harmful pathogens. So these are the two different types of divisions of the immune system, or two responses. We have the innate immunity response that takes an effect immediately, and we have the acquired immunity response that usually takes several days to actually take an effect. Now, innate immunity is not learned by the body. We are essentially born with this type of immunity because we are born with skin, we are born with the mucous membranes, and so forth. But this is the type of system that utilizes these different specialized cells that carry out a specific type of function and which kill off and destroy specific type of pathogens that enter our body.